According to Rosemary Kisembo, the executive director of NERA, starting June this year, the authority will be carrying out the mass enrollment for the national ID renewal. The exercise, scheduled to last 10 months, will first consider Ugandans aged 16 years and above.
This will cover every piece of ground in this country. It will take place at the 10,717 parishes in this country.
The NERA boss further reveals that, unlike previously, where only the face and fingerprints were captured on the national IDs, in the new exercise, they will add the individual's iris. This, according to Kisembo, is intended to promote inclusivity.
Converted to the level that we can understand it in a pattern and stored in a secure barcode, we shall encrypt it behind that barcode.
She explains that with Uganda's population being at 45 million, the National Identification Register currently has only 27 million people, noting that the exercise seeks to add between 17 to 18 million Ugandans, including minors, who will be issued national identification numbers, while the adults will be given cards. Ugandans abroad will also be registered.
Every Ugandan, regardless of age, regardless of sex, regardless of religion, regardless of background, regardless of occupation, regardless of tribe, regardless of clan, is entitled to a national identification number.
From the Uganda Police Force, police have arrested a 27-year-old Ibrahim Musana for abusing and defaming Buganda Kingdom officials, including the Kabaka Ronald Muwenda Mutebi and the Katikiro Charles Peter Mayiga, in videos that went viral on social media.
Was picked following a series of reported hate crimes, acts of incitement to violence, defamation of the Kabaka of Buganda, the Katikiro, and a lot of offensive communication through various digital platforms, on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp. And so the suspect was handed over to the Directorate of CID in Chibuli.
According to Enanga, after arrest by the Crime Intelligence, Musana was handed over to the Criminal Investigations Directorate, where detectives are now processing him on various charges of misusing of social media, hate speech, offensive communication and incitement to violence. At least 50 videos posted by Musana are being previewed by security operatives.
Actually transcribing over 50 videos of anti-Kabaka sentiments that are vulgar, abusive, hostile and defamatory. Why we are transcribing them is for evidential purposes.
Also, the Uganda police has refuted claims of mismanagement of police officers' funds under the police exodus circle. This follows an order by parliament directing the exodus police circle to stop the mandatory deduction of personnel's salaries as savings. Senior Commissioner of Police Wilson Omoding, the chairperson of the police exodus circle, explains that the alleged 50% deduction is not true.
That issue that became contentious about the 50% which people misunderstood. The 50% was not about deducting the officer's salary. The public service standing orders does not allow you to deduct an officer's salary more than a half of that salary. What the Exodus Circle management and guided by the AGM, that officers should access their savings 50% and also contribute to the savings for retirement.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.